Michael Bromwich promised that the team he assembles for this task will be lean and efficient and will get answers to questions about the gun trace task force, namely, what happened and why, how did it happen, who facilitated that, and who failed to stop it.
They have placed no limitations on us, no artificial time constraints, no investigative constraints of any kind.
Attorney Michael Bromwich introduced Wednesday as the independent investigator hired to figure out how the gun trace task force happened. The review and report, a long-awaited mandate under the federal consent decree.
The department needs answers, and Baltimore residents deserve them. Getting the answers is a vital part of the reform process and our culture change.
City police and lawyers completely hands-off, officials said today. No control over the process or product. City Solicitor Andre Davis said with this approach, the BPD is opening itself up to legal and liability risks, but it's worth it.
To expose the malignancy that grew in this department, we are ready to move forward.
Bromwich, called uniquely qualified for the job, previously served as an independent monitor of the D.C. Police Department, tapped to regulate offshore drilling after the Deepwater Horizon disaster, recently represented an accuser of now U.S. Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh during confirmation hearings on the Hill. As for this new assignment,
that a full and complete airing of the facts, with absolutely no punches pulled, will promote the healing process that this city and this police department so badly need.
There is no time frame on Mr. Bromwich's work here. As you heard him mention, the city solicitor said they have no idea if it'll take 3 months, 6 or 9 months, a year, or even a year and a half. And Mr. Bromwich today said if there had been a time limitation, he wouldn't have taken this job. Reporting live from police headquarters tonight, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.